Hello, everyone. Welcome in. It's February 2nd. It's time for Up the Archer here on Cardiff Met Sport TV. Now, first of all, it's February 2nd. Nobody here seems to know that it's Groundhog Day. Only me. But if you've never heard of it, Groundhog Day is this weird American tradition we have. There's this groundhog, Punxsutawney Phil, this overweight beaver thing that comes out of the ground. If he sees his shadow, winter continues for 6 more weeks. If he doesn't see his shadow, spring will start the following week. Dumbest tradition ever. It's super weird. Nobody really celebrates it, but it's a weird holiday, and we all wear beaver masks for a day or do weird things like that. I thought it was funny because it comes from a Welsh enclave in the United States. Morgantown is where it originated. So I figured it'd be celebrated here, but my producer and assistants have all told me it's not. So anyway, there's your fun fact for the day. It's strange. Anyway, today's Groundhog Day. We have plenty of football information coming up for you, men's and women's. We have plenty to look forward to. So first of all here, let's take a look at what's coming up on today's edition of Cardiff Met Sport TV. First, we have highlights from the men's semifinal victory over local rivals Barry Town, and next, the women's as they won last Sunday against also local rivals Swansea. I'll be joined by guests from both teams, Alex Lang and Craig Davis from the men's side, and Eliana Chavez from the women's as well. But first, to get you there, let's take a look back at the highlights from the men's victory over Barry Town last November. Barry, ball thrown up the wing. It's headed up, headed in behind. Cotterill's going to get his foot to it. It looks like it's too high. Oh, no, that's actually dropped in. From here, it doesn't look like it was going to drop in, but it did. Cotterill managed to chip Lang from 20 yards out after just a random header in behind. I didn't think that was going to happen. Ball sent up the field now. It's in the middle of the field here. McCarthy with it. Slings it over to the side. Evans now. Evans, open shot. It's on the ground. Saved. Kicked away. Good shot. Good save. Wide open along that wing. Evans had plenty of space. Could have done better with that. Ball in the middle here again. Chubb, 35 yards. That shot's palmed away, tipped away by the goalkeeper. Man, that was impressive. From that distance, looked like it was arrowing to the top corner. Great one-handed save on that. McCarthy again. McCarthy's left foot. He sends that into the front post. Reese gets to it. Reese is kicked from behind, and the referee will give a penalty on this. Reese was kicked in the back as he went to the ball. Great cross in from Kyle McCarthy. Reese got to it first. Lewis Reese found. Barry, ball thrown up the wall along the ground. Maybe a slight deflection, but that drops in. McCarthy now, long ball over. Evans at the top of the box. Evans 20 yards away. His shot rifled into the top right corner. Cardiff Met take another big lead. 3-1 here. They've got 1 foot in the final now. Great shot here from Evans. Right foot, top of right corner. Goalkeeper, no chance on that one. This long ball sent up now. Barry looking for anything at the end, near the end of this game. That shot, it's on the ground. It looks like it's going in. How did that miss? Alex Lang looked like he might not have had that covered. This shot trickled just wide of the post. I mean, it was inches wide. Ball in midfield here. Barry have it. They've stolen the ball back now. Driving to the byline. Cross sent over. McDonald's wide open. McDonald's header. How did McDonald miss that? Wide open from 5 yards out. Alex Lang nowhere near that one. McDonald's open header goes wide, and I don't know how he missed it. Sent back in from Evans here, looking for Roscrow. Doesn't find him. Barry clear it away. It's sent back. Chubb now. Chubb sends it over. Roscrow gets his foot to it, but it's deflected away. Chubb's got the ball back. He'll play it back here. Evans again. Evans, another cross. Roscrow's there. Roscrow puts it in the back of the net. Cardiff Met take a 4-1 lead. Oh, but this one will be called back. He's offside. Looks like he was offside on this Evans cross here. Yeah, he was off by an inch. Barry now, as we come into the last 2 minutes of the game, looking for anything they can get. Cross sent over. It's at the top of the box, and that one's knocked in past Max Manson. Just got in behind the defense. I don't know what happened there. He just beat everybody. Inside the six-yard box, left wide open by three guys.
I apologize for the technical glitch in the middle of that video, but thank you to S4C for allowing us to use their coverage of that match. An impressive win for Cardiff Met, 3-2 over local rivals Barry Town in the semifinal. Now, Alex, thank you for joining me here today. You were the goalkeeper for Cardiff Met that day. I don't know if it really could be called a rivalry if you guys are beating Barry Town three times in a year, but that's all right. What about that victory for the team? How does that change everyone's confidence ahead of the final now?
Yeah, I think it was a massive game. Like you say, like local rivals, I think that's always puts a bit of fire in the belly, even for a semi-final. But yeah, like it was a great game, and we knew the importance of it moving forward as well, and now we've got a reward for it.
Now remind me, Cardiff Met last won the Nathaniel MG Cup back in 2019. You were the goalkeeper that day, correct?
Yeah.
That was your first year here, right?
Yeah.
So what's different now, 2 years after that? What's changed from this team? Is there any difference between this team and that one that you see?
I think there's been a bit of a personnel change, and obviously the players who may have been a bit more inexperienced at that time are now the senior players and leading the team forward as well, which I think is really good. I think in terms of confidence, I think we've got that behind us as well. We know we've done it before, and I think that's helped us build, and we've had Europe since then as well. So I think that's given us the confidence to move forward.
Now, when you look at this game, this will be up in Pennebont. Is that kind of a home field advantage for you guys? It's not your home field, of course, but it's not too far away either. You've played at Pennebont before. You guys like the stadium? What's it like there for you?
Yeah, it's very similar pitch to ours, really. It's a nice ground, and like you say, it's about a 30-minute drive down the M4, so it's not too far for us, whereas I know for Kornski they have to travel a little bit further. But I think we're hoping to bring quite a big support as well, and I think that'll definitely help us on the day as well.
Yeah. Now, Kornski, they seem to be, by most accounts, favored, whether it's because of the results they've had this season or maybe how big the club is, but you guys have played them twice, once at home and on the road. You've drawn both times, and now you've got this game up against them here. Would you guys agree that they are favorites, or does that really matter to you guys at all?
Well, we know the talent they have and the quality they have. You know, they were league champions last year. Like, that's nothing to be looked over. I think they're a great team. And like you said, the games this year have been close, which shows we can compete. But I think even if we were conceding as the underdogs, I think that's a benefit to us, because I think that's when we tend to do our best, is when we shouldn't do our best. And I think that's something we can use to our advantage as well.
Yeah. Now, it's interesting. We talk about the gap between the two sides. They're in sixth. You guys are in eighth in the league right now. Only a difference of 4 points. We spoke to your fellow teammate CJ Craven yesterday. He joked that the real difference between the two teams is just the height. That's about it. Connors Key's pretty tall. You guys, not so much. Nothing wrong with that, of course. Yeah. I think that's awesome. Yeah. But when you guys go into this game, are you guys nervous of any certain tactical thing that they may do? Are you guys nervous about set pieces from them? What are you looking to stop most of all from Connors Key?
Yeah, I think set pieces is a big threat of theirs. I think they like to get the ball in the box. They've got talented individuals. Like I say, they got players from last year who took them to that league title. So they've got talented players, we know, but we've done our research. I think we're quietly confident about it. I think we'll be set for any challenges they have for us.
Awesome. Yeah. Now, Sam Jones, he's just come into the team for Cardiff Met. Now, he actually played for Cambrian and Clydach back in 2019, correct?
Yeah.
Did you save any shots of his in that game? Anything to rub back at?
Oh, I can't remember. I don't think I did. I know they put a lot of pressure on us that day, though, so they could have had a couple of goes, but because Joe Evans, our defender, played that day as well, and we've given him a bit of stick about it, but I think Christian, our coach, said he wants to make sure they get on the winning team this time.
So yeah.
That's what we'll be making sure of.
No, that's good to hear.
Yeah.
Now, speaking of Coach Edwards here, this is his last season here at Cardiff Met. This may be his last chance to get a trophy here with you guys. Is the team excited for that? Is that a little bit of an extra push for you guys, or not so much?
Yeah, I think it's something that hasn't really been spoken about too much, but I think it's in the back of everyone's mind. I think he's done so much for the club. I think that goes without saying.
Yeah.
He's been first team coach here for so many years, and the impact he's had is massive. And obviously it is his last year this year. So I think that is an extra push for us, I think, because he's done so much for everyone. I think it would be nice to give it back.
No, absolutely. Now, speaking of that and going into, this is still a while away, of course, but for next season, have they spoken to you about any succession plan in place, or do you guys have much of an idea what's going to come next?
Yeah, we have spoken about it. I think there's not going to be too much of a change. I think one of the current coaches now is going to be me taking more of a leadership role in the team, which is great. He gets on really well with everyone, and it's something people are excited for. But obviously there will be just some transition, because Christian's so important, such an influence in the club.
No,
I think but I think it will be nice having someone who's already involved and knows the club really well to take over from Christian.
Awesome. Well, Alex, thank you for your time today. We're excited to go to this final on Sunday. Hopefully you guys will get a win out of this.
Yeah, I hope so. Thank you very much.
Awesome. Now we have a bit of a test coming up here. We have Reese Jones, a fellow Cardiff Met Sport TV analyst. He's going to analyze some of Cardiff Met's recent results and performance. We'll see what other Cardiff Met player Craig Davis thinks of this, coming back from this break right here.
Hello, this is Reese Jones with Cardiff Met Sport TV, and welcome to Archer Analysis.
So
So looking ahead to Sunday's Nathaniel MG Cup final against Connors Quay, there are a few key areas that I think are either going to win or lose Cardiff Met this match. First, I want to look at the archers in transition. Connors Quay here whip the ball into the box and Cardiff Met get a clearance and look to recoup and recover. Cardiff Met's momentum with Adam Roscoe pressing the keeper is all going towards the opposition goal, okay? But as we watch this play out, Connors Quay, their goalkeeper, clears the ball all the way up the pitch. And let's go back just a second there. And we see one, two, and three Cardiff Met defenders static, not ready to turn and run with the forwards, whereas the forwards have their momentum all going towards goal. This results in a very, very easy counterattack, easy chip finish, and 1-0. That cannot happen on the weekend. A second example here, Cardiff Met give up a little bit of silly possession, and it only takes one over-the-top through ball to create a one-on-one situation that nearly results in a goal. However, I don't want to be negative because Cardiff Met can use the transition to their advantage. As we watch this one play out in the semi-final, Barry have a corner kick, we get the clearance out, and we look to go on the counter-attack. And I want you to keep your eyes on the player with the ball, but also the runs being made from the midfield. Okay, keep your eyes on the back post, and all the way back there, Met have created a 2-versus-1 scenario at that back post. And as we watch this play out, it does result in a very good shooting opportunity, a shot on goal. We take those. Now I want to look at how Cardiff Met defend the second ball, okay? And what I mean by that, as you'll see here, is what happens after a near post flick, okay? Pay attention to that attacker there. That attacker gets that ball. Cardiff Met are flat-footed, and it results in a shot on target. However, offside trap was played. It was called offsides, no goal. However, in the same game, the same lapse in concentration happens. We see all the focus, all the eyes of the players right here, where all that cluster of players is, and nobody is too bothered about the 2-versus-2 on the 6-yard box. This results, even though his back was to goal, it results in a shot on the post, something that we just cannot afford on the weekend if we have a chance at winning this final. And finally, set pieces can be one of the most important things in a cup final. Whether the game is going your way, momentum is going your way, it only takes one set piece to go right or wrong to completely change the result of a game. Let's keep an eye here on Emlyn Lewis on the corner kick. And we see what really matters when it comes to a set piece is who's gonna react first to that first or second ball, okay? On this second chance here, a little bit more of a chaotic play, not as straightforward of a technique in terms of a set piece, but all that matters for Met is they're trying to get that ball back in the box, and as long as they're the first to react, it can result in a shot on target. But nobody knows what's really gonna happen. The only way to find out, show up at Pennebont at 2 p.m. on Sunday. We'll see you there.
Thank you, Reese. Now, Reese has mentioned a little bit about how Cardiff Met like to play, how they like to attack on the counter here, and we'll look and see what that will mean for the upcoming final this Sunday. I'm joined here by Cardiff Met midfielder Craig Davis. Craig, how are you today?
Yeah, good, thanks.
Awesome. Now, we want you to take a look at that, what Reese just spoke about there, how you guys like to play on the counter attack, move up the field quickly, try to take advantage of any dispossession you guys get. Would you agree with that? Cardiff Met likes to play on the counter a lot? What would you think of that?
Yeah, I'd say so. We're also a team which likes to have the possession of the ball a lot, so we like to pass it as well. But sometimes in games when we do find ourselves having to maybe sit in and drop back, it's definitely something that we try and use, especially when there's spaces and stuff in behind the defence. So it's definitely another string to our bow, which we like to sort of implement, depending on the game really and how that's going.
Now, speaking of that, with Connors Quay coming up, Connors Quay, they seem to be the favorites in this game. Maybe it's just traditional, maybe it's something else. But against Connors Quay, and you don't have to go too deeply into your game plan here, of course, but do you guys plan on trying to keep the ball for a long time? Or are you guys planning on a counterattack-based style? Anything specific from you?
I mean, it depends on how the game's going. I mean, there will be times where we'll try and do our own sort of plays and our own ways that we're trying to play, so we'll try and do our bit, but then they'll have their style as well. They're pretty direct and stuff, so
yeah.
There'll be periods in the game where we'll maybe have to deal with their longer balls, and because they're quite a physical team, we'll have to deal with that. So yeah, it depends on how the game's going, but
yeah.
As a team in general, we like to dominate possession and play to our strengths.
Yeah. Now, speaking of that directness that you mentioned, let's be direct about one thing here, too. Your last six games, 3 wins, 3 draws, big change in form here. Big part of that are the goals. 10 goals in your last six, and another part of that is Adam Roscoe. He's really managed to change things, I think, offensively. Things have managed to go pretty well in these past 6 games. Would you attribute that to something Adam's done differently, or is it something the team has done differently? What's happened that's causing this?
Yeah, Adam's been doing really well for us, to be fair, and he's been scoring quite a few goals. But it's mainly just, I think, the team as a whole. We've all been working together, especially on the training pitch.
Yeah.
So it's been nice seeing stuff from the training pitch, implementing that, and then going into a game. But yeah, Adam is like one piece of the puzzle, but then we've got other players as well who can chip in with goals as well.
Yeah. Now, one thing that Coach Edwards mentioned after you guys' last victory, or he mentioned that the team has really had a big change this year, a big change and improvement based on what the team was last year. Mm-hmm. Is that something that you see as a player as well? Lots of improvement all around?
Yeah, I've seen a lot of improvement. This is my second year now at Cardiff Met.
Yeah.
Last year was really tough. I mean, the difference between this year and last year, with the way we've been playing and the points we've been picking up, it's a big difference, to be fair. So
yeah.
We have improved a lot. I think we've adjusted to stuff with injuries and all the different consequences, especially with COVID, players being out. Last year we maybe couldn't really quite adjust to stuff happening game to game, but this year I think we should have really blended more as a team. And that should have shown with the amount of points we picked up this year compared to last year.
Yeah, no, of course. Now, I don't mean to bring this up too often, but this is obviously Christian Edwards' last season here at Cardiff Met. Does that have an impact on you every day in the training ground or anything that you do? Does that make you see things a bit differently for how this season is going? What kind of impact does that have on you personally?
Maybe. I mean, he's been here for such a long time, and everyone values his the work and the information that he gives us on the training pitch. So, yeah, it's going to be a really tough game for us on Sunday, and we'll definitely try to win it, not just for him, but for everyone else involved. And
yeah.
Yeah, hopefully we can do Aaron proud, Cardiff Met proud on Sunday.
Awesome. Now you're hoping for a win on Sunday. You're expecting a win on Sunday deep inside, aren't you?
Yeah, well, we'll do our best. We're always underdogs, especially coming up against Connors Quay.
Yeah.
But I think that tag sort of, it doesn't do any bad things for us. We try and use that to our advantage. So
awesome. Well, Craig, thank you. I know we're all excited to go this Sunday. I'm excited to see, hopefully, a Cardiff Met victory here.
Hopefully.
Now, speaking of that, let's actually tell you all how to get to this final here on this Sunday. So the game starts at 2 o'clock p.m. This is the road to Pennebon, as we'll call it. Cardiff Met against Connors Quay. This will be held in SDM Glass Stadium, again, in Pennebon. It's about a 30 to 45-minute drive this Sunday, February 6th at 2 o'clock p.m. It's £5 for students to go on the bus to get to this game. That bus leaves from outside the Student Union at 12:15 p.m. So you need to be here about a few minutes before, and then we'll go ahead and get out at 12:15 and support the team there at 2 o'clock p.m. So show up this Sunday. We'd love to see you there. Obviously, the more fans, the better. We need to make this a home field advantage for Cardiff Met. Again, it's only 30 minutes away for us. For Connors Quay, it's like 4 hours. Why don't we take advantage of that? Let's get a win here for the Archers. Now, coming up here, we'll be joined here by Ileana Chavez in just a moment. But first, let's take a look at the key highlights from the women's victory in the Welsh Trophy this past Sunday over Swansea City.
The quarterfinal of the Adran Trophy is underway. Cardiff Met versus Swansea Ladies. Chavez turning inside out. Oh, and that's a wild challenge there from the Swansea defender. Referee blows his whistle then. Allen smashes it into the net. And Cardiff Met lead here in this quarter-final tie. 1-0. Lake goes long, looking for Chivers as Webb loses out there. Chivers looks to try and get a shot off herself, and she does, to find the bottom left-hand corner. Penalty shootout. These two teams have been here before. couple of years back now, the prolific Emily Allen, who marches forward to take the first penalty for Cardiff Met. Emily Allen stands over it. She scored last week against Cardiff City. She scored today. Can she score again? Oh, and she hits the bar. She looked like she rushed that one. As Adams steps up first for the Swans, places the ball. Adams. And it is saved by Annabelle Sweeney. She came on as a substitute in the second half for Cardiff Met. Can she score here? She can. Bottom right corner. Short run up. Referee blows his whistle. And the left-footed shot is stopped as Annabelle Sweeney guesses correctly again for Cardiff Met. And it is advantage for the home team. Hutton Townsend to take the next penalty for Cardiff Met. And she make it 2-0 for the Archers. And it is slotted away. It's very central run-up. And this penalty shootout has very much gone in favour for Cardiff Met. And it's the fullback Oakley to take the third penalty for Swansea. Will it be third time lucky for the away team? Oakley then. Neatly finished to put it away. Another substitute for Cardiff Met who came on in this game. Mills, she came on for Webb. Centre half. And to make it 3-1. And she does slot it in. The shootout is nicely going in favour for the Archers. And it's the Swansea number 12, John Davis. She's looked very lively this match. Very energetic player. John Davis. Very good finish there with the right foot. The skipper, Turner. To make it 4-2 in his penalty shootout. Oh, and that's a very nice finish to end the things here at Kincoyd Campus. Cardiff Met advance through to the semi-final of the Adran Trophy. And they are amazing scenes. Commiserations to Swansea. They fought valiantly in that first half to respond to the penalty after going 1-0 down. It was a very quick reply, but neither team taking full grasp of the game in the second half, and it had to be decided on penalties. But it is Cardiff Met who come out on top.
Now, it's an impressive win for the women's side over their rivals, Swansea. And they really are rivals, as we'll talk about in a minute, just here with Eliana Chavez. Eliana, thank you for joining me today.
Thank you for having me. Yeah, great.
Now, I know you've got a Bucks game after this, so thank you for taking the time to meet us right before doing that. First of all, though, we'll go back to that victory over Swansea. I know they've beaten you twice in the league this season. How nice did that one feel to beat them in that quarterfinal?
Yeah, it was great. Obviously, we knew it was a big challenge going into the game. And, you know, we did our preparation for the week, practices, all that. So, it felt amazing, you know, to get the result that we ultimately wanted.
Yeah. Now, one thing I noticed with all the penalties, everybody was so confident. I mean, they took 2-3 steps up and just put them right in. No questions asked. It looked pretty easy. And from your goalkeeper as well, from Annabelle Sweeney, also pretty simple. Where's all this confidence coming from for you guys?
Yeah, I think it's just, you know, all the games we've been winning. I think we're at eight or nine consecutive wins this season. So, yeah, I think it just stems from that. And, you know, just you know, all of us have confidence in each other and just believing in each other, really. So, yeah, when people stepped up and said they wanted the PK, the penalty kick, we all just had confidence that they were going to put them in the back of the net, and that's exactly what they did. So.
Yeah. Now, I know you won the first penalty of the game, not in the shootout, of course, but the one before, mm-hmm. and then you didn't take any penalties after. Yeah. I was joking with you before. Are we going to see one today in your Bucks game later? When's your next penalty coming up?
Yeah, we'll see. We'll see. I haven't taken one in a couple of years, but yeah, next one. I promise I'll take.
Fair enough. Now, speaking about the team's form here, obviously you guys have done really well this season. Swansea has really been the only challenge, I think, so far. The only thing that's taken you guys back away. I know you guys play Swansea in another, not this Sunday, but the following up in Swansea. You guys need to beat them to stay in the race for the Adrian League, the Sunday League, and then today, of course, you could win the Bucks League as well, but mostly for that Swansea game. You guys really need a result that next Sunday. Have you guys been planning a lot for that game against Swansea? What are you guys looking at to beat them again?
So I think going into the last game, like I said, we knew it was going to be challenging. And, you know, going into that first half, I don't think we were really happy with our performance. It just was very chaotic, and you could tell there were nerves, you know, initially. But going into that second half and during halftime, we kind of talked about, you know, we want to play the Cardiff Met way, we want to get the ball down, play the way we know how to play, and I think in the second half we did that, and I think that's the game plan just going forward, you know, having confidence in ourselves and just knowing, you know, that we can go into the game and play the Cardiff Met way, you know, get the ball down, play, and then things will come, you know.
That's interesting you mentioned that. A lot of this chemistry you guys have, the confidence the whole team has, the whole connection. We talked about 30 seconds before coming on the air. You told me you and Annabelle Sweeney actually went to the same school in Texas.
Right.
How are so many Americans finding their way out to here in Cardiff?
Right. So our coach actually from back home knew a few of the coaches here, so it kind of worked out perfectly, but it was a complete coincidence that both of us came to the same school. But obviously, yeah, on the field we have that chemistry. You know, she knows where I know where she'll do, and she knows how I like the ball, like over the top and things like that. So, yeah it definitely works in our favor, I think. Yeah.
No, that's awesome. Now, how is it that obviously, Americans keep coming here. This has been the last 5 years in a row now that American women have been on the Cardiff Met women's team. What is that something that they are asking you to do, or something you're doing subconsciously? Are you still advertising for Cardiff Met? What are you guys doing?
Yeah, not really. I think some of the girls actually from back home, you know, that were a bit younger than us on our university team are kind of wondering, you know, what is it like? And, you know, questioning, you know, because I kind of talked about this in another interview, but just, you know, talking about how when you're, you know, 22, 21, 22, you're pretty much finished with your university and your soccer career is kind of done. And I think for me and Annabelle, we just weren't really ready to be finished. And so with COVID hit, we lost our last year of eligibility. And so we came here and it's been amazing, you know, and I think, you know, we could be playing the next couple of years, and obviously playing side by side, like doing our masters and things like that, is just like a win-win on both ends. So I think a lot of Americans, it'll be very enticing for a lot of Americans.
Oh, of course. Now, with Cardiff Met especially, do you feel like your game is progressing here? You feel like your game has become a lot better here? How is the Cardiff Met environment changing your football game?
Right, yeah. So I came last January, so I've been here for about a year, but it definitely took a lot of time to get to know, you know, the players and how, you know, what the Cardiff Met way is and how to really play. And so, yeah, that took quite a bit of time. But I think as well as, you know, coming from the U.S., I'm able to offer something that maybe they don't see all the time here.
Yeah.
And I think over the past year, we've kind of developed, you know, whether it's with like Ellie Priest or Emily Allen up top or whoever's up top,
sure.
Just learning how to play with one another. And it took time to, you know, really understand and, you know, gaining confidence within each other and all of that. But once we kind of learned how to play, you can see with all the consecutive wins and everything that we've really been learning how to play off each other, and it's been great.
Awesome. Now, one more question for you as well. What do you think of Wales? I know it's a lot different from Texas, where you're from.
Yeah.
What's it like here?
Can't say I love the weather, you know, being from Texas, but yeah, it's been good. It's a lovely city. It has like that small town feel, but also it can be pretty big as well.
Yeah,
it's gorgeous. And I love it. I want to stay if I can, so yeah.
I'd say that's pretty good. That's a pretty good endorsement for Cardiff right there. Well, up next, we're going to have an interview with actually one of your fellow teammates, Liv Thompson, another American. We'll have a feature interview here with her coming up next.
Hi, I'm Olivia Thompson, and I play football for Cardiff Met.
My first year at Cardiff Met was a really successful one. We won the treble, we won the league, we won the FA Cup, we won the League Cup, and we got another bid in the Champions League the next season, which was really exciting because I had done quite well with the team. I got recognized by one of the biggest clubs at home, Orlando Pride, which was really a big honor for me because they're just a massive team and I've always dreamed of playing for them. I was on a week-long trial, and when I got invited back following that trial, I tore my ACL on the first day of the next week. It was just, the timing of it wasn't great. It was really gutting, but it is what it is. It happened. Then I was now left without a team. But Cardiff Met lovingly took me back. And then about a week or two later, everything went into lockdown.
You must stay at home.
And that was really frustrating to have, you know, been out of football for so long. And then to now be back into it, for it to only get taken away once again was quite a frustrating time. So probably in a bit of a state of panic of like wanting to keep my football and wanting a new challenge following everything with the ACL and obviously having won the treble, I decided to go off to Cardiff City in the English tier system. And that was a great experience. I learned so much. They had so many great players and helped definitely grow my game. But I don't know, it was just something kind of calling me back to Met, especially this season. Every time, you know, John Denver, Country Roads comes on, you know, you just, small part of you is still singing, Take Me Home, King Coyd Road. It just, the decision became quite clear that coming back to Cardiff Met was the thing that I had to be doing. Oh, what I love most about Cardiff Met is just probably the girls and the team. It's just such a good vibe and such a good atmosphere about it. And they're one of the most successful teams in Wales, especially within the Welsh Prem. And I really want to help the team get back to that Champions League spot.
I think my first goal back in the ACL, I scored in here. It was a bit of a tap-in, so don't tell anyone, but still counts. They all count the same. Scored a goal against Swansea down on that one. Some definitely good memories out here with the girls. Lots of wins, lots of goals. Yeah, some really good times out here.
Winning the league with Met was a really fun experience. Just to be so dominant that year and to have the team that we did was so much fun. I think we'd go into every game and we were just out there just enjoying ourselves. Like, to win the treble, to taste that victory, to have that experience, you don't really want to go back to anything short of it. So I definitely think that winning the league and winning those cups is the main goal for me as a player. I'll happily do whatever it takes to get to that. This is definitely the final few months for me here in the UK, and I couldn't think of anything better than going out with some trophies and winning with the girls would be great, and helping them get to that Champions League spot for next summer and seeing them on their way. And yeah, just couldn't think of anything better.
The coolest part, I think, about this is we have some seriously great players in all levels of football here at Cardiff Met. Men's, women's, Bucks League, whatever. Everyone here is seriously talented. You'll have a chance, actually, to see some upcoming games for Cardiff Met. Come to these games. This is where you can best see all of the great players that we have here. Tonight, we have the women's team up against USW, another local rival. They're playing for the Bucks Championship tonight. A draw, a win, any kind of result, they're going to win the league. And then, again, on Sunday, remember to get outside the Student Union before 12:15, bring along 5 pounds. That's your way to get to the final over in Pennebont. Join us then. We'll see you then on this Sunday. Thank you for joining us here on Up the Archer here for Cardiff Met Sport TV. Before we go, we'll leave you guys with the best of montage we've done of all the best Cardiff Met goals throughout the start of the year. Thank you, and have a great Groundhog's Day.
Sky. Zeta.
Up the speaker. You can use my arm to lean on. Babe, don't run, don't leave us. It took us years to see love. She runs, but I can't keep up. I feel beat up, so I get lean up. She's sweet like sugar in teacups. Good energies when we team up. But when you're gonna lose focus, without you, I can't process. Inside, I'm feeling hopeless. This ashtray's filled with roaches. You said I'm too controlling. So you got your options open. That thing that we had was golden. Don't run, don't leave me broken.